On today's episode of Huber Syndrome, I am joined by none other than the co-creator of Huber Syndrome, Don Casanova.
Good day.
Don, I like to get you in front of the camera at least once a year.
Once a year, the time has come.
And what better time than the holidays?
All right.
How are you feeling this holiday season? I know the last holiday season, obviously 2020, is really crazy. 2021, still kind of intense out there.
Yeah.
How are you feeling?
I'm feeling good. They've come up faster than I expected. Like, the holidays always come up fast, but usually I have, like, a nice month of listening to Christmas music when I'm driving and stuff.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it feels like I just got on board a couple days ago. They really snuck up quick.
What are your?
But I'm feeling great.
Feeling great. What are your go-to Christmas songs? How many you can list?
I like almost every Christmas song, but Huber, I think you're one of the few people that might appreciate this. It's going to be a surprise, I think. Not expected.
Unexpected.
Very popular. One of the most popular. In fact, maybe the most popular. Do you know what it is?
I am really partial to George Michael.
Oh, okay. That's
I
a beautiful.
I love
that. I love him too.
10 out of 10.
Yeah, that's 10 out of 10.
Yeah.
Mariah Carey.
I should have guessed that.
But guess what? So I love that Mariah Carey song so much.
Yeah.
But I realized just recently there's another one that's in the same vein, same vibes, that in fact I may have like been slightly switching these around in my mind. Like maybe when I was hearing it, I was like, oh, the Mariah Carey.
Yeah.
Kelly Clarkson.
Kelly Clarkson, she's got some bangers.
That song is so good.
Yes.
And I realized it's the song that they would play at Grinchmas every year at Universal Studios.
Sick.
So in a way, that's like the most pop music I would ever like,
you
know what I mean? But I love it, so.
What's my mom, I remember, used to have the VHSs of, like, Mannheim Steamroller?
Is that what it's called?
Yeah, she used to rock that shit so hard.
Yeah.
That's
I
so
love
jolly.
Listening to Christmas music when I'm driving.
Same. Yeah, this Halloween, Don, was not ruined, but this Halloween, I had to go to a wedding in Northern California on the 30th.
Uh-huh.
So then I was there also on the 31st. So my Halloween was kind of like cut short and impeded on.
Mm-hmm.
So for Christmas now, we've gone all in.
Yeah.
We got the tree, we got the lights,
yeah.
we got like the little houses with little trees.
I love that stuff. I love that so much.
I am obsessed with that stuff. I'm just now starting a collection though. This is like my first year of like, yo, I'm an adult now.
Yeah.
I'm gonna like collect.
They're not cheap.
We started small, kind of just like wooden little ones, not super fancy or crazy. So we're a little bare bones now. I gotta get like a street or something to kind of connect it all.
You could put a train around there.
Yeah.
That's fun.
That's ambitious.
Yeah, I used to put a train around the tree a lot. I don't have a train this year, but I used to put little houses with it, you know what I mean?
What?
Yep, but now I don't have a train this year, but I do have some of the little houses and I put the Christmas lights, like the excess lights that were hanging, I like stuck them in the back, because these houses were actually just the frames. They're not like the self-lit ones.
Got it.
It's kind of cool because I actually put them in the pot, like around, you know, and then I put little Ewoks and stuff. It's a
so
cool little
sick.
Scene. It's a cool scene, yeah.
Dude, when did you stop doing the train?
The train, I stopped a couple years ago. The train was a frustrating thing. I had a couple trains, but I'd set it up, and it's beautiful. But my cat, like, would sit there.
Yeah, the cat.
And the train goes around, and it would just go, bunk, and knock it off. And I'm like, dang it. And I have to get off the couch and, like, perfectly put the little things back in the track.
Yeah.
It was a small scale, you know?
Yeah.
And just over and over and over. And, so I just didn't take it out of the box this year.
Cat,
I didn't want to deal with it. Yeah.
For sure.
Cats, yeah.
John, we talked about music. We talked about festivities.
Yep.
Do you have any Christmas movies?
Absolutely.
That are no matter what.
Yeah.
Every year. What are they?
Yeah. I already knocked a few of them out.
Yeah.
I've already done the ultra classic Vacation, Christmas Story.
Yeah.
But the one thing that I haven't watched yet that I do like to do every holiday season, I haven't done it this year yet. Well, usually I do this like on the actual couple days around Christmas. The Hobbit trilogy in 3D.
The Hobbit trilogy?
You know,
that is cozy.
You know, it's the coziest ever. You know, I have my 3D collection. I don't get all the time to watch them, but every Christmas time, because all those original movies, The Hobbit, a lot of people aren't fans of them. I'm a huge fan.
I really like the first two a lot.
I love the third one. I'm one of the only people on earth that loves the third one also.
I love the second one.
Yeah. The second one's brilliant.
Yeah.
They're all brilliant. I really like the first them all. I think they're all just super entertaining. And not just that, but a lot of the love for me is actually connected to just the nostalgia of seeing all three of those movies with, like,
high frame rate.
High frame rate, but a family, too. Because very few movies I get to see. I remember seeing, I think, The First Hobbit with my grandma, my uncle was there, people I never see movies with. It would be the only time, like, you'd get, like, some weird mishmash of family going to the theater together.
Oh, that's so magical.
I remember my uncle with, like, bags of, he brought in all kinds of his own snacks. I'll never forget
watching
The Hobbit, and he's handing down, like, Ziploc bags of carrots and stuff. And, like, granola or something.
Yes!
It was awesome.
Yes!
But so every year I like to do that. I like to do the Hobbit trilogy. And if I can, I do it in a whole day, back to back to back. Just make a day. I don't know if that's even possible now. But
do regular or extended
I'll
cuts?
I'll try it. I go back to regular.
Controversially, Don, I was doing the rewatch recently when they came to 4K of Lord of the Rings.
Okay.
And ever since the extended DVDs came out way back then, I've always been a defender of the extendeds for Lord of the Rings, like big time.
Yep.
This time around was the very first time that I questioned it. Like, okay, maybe it does kind of mess with the pacing, or maybe it does kind of take a little bit of thematic weight away.
It's a lot to ask, especially if you're doing back to back to back. That's
I usually go like one a day.
Yeah.
3 days, I feel like.
I try to do them in a row if I can, but the 3D is pretty important to me. Those movies look fantastic.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And they're just fun. Like the third one, you know, it's just a popcorn movie.
Crazy.
It's just whatever, like entertainment.
Watch it again in a few years, re-examine it.
It's just entertainment. Yeah, you can't get too worried about the plot. It's just a lot of action.
Chaos.
Just big battle, spectacle. Yeah. But I like that, you know.
Christmas is coming up.
Oh, Home Alone, you know,
Of course, I watched
the new Home Alone. I was telling you this. I love.
He's been selling it.
I love it.
I haven't seen
it yet.
Hard.
I could not believe it's like, talk about a movie with the most baggage possible. How could you ever be successful making a new? And they did it. They just pulled it off. I don't know how to say it, but they pulled it off. Yeah, it's just jolly. You're 20 minutes in and you're like, actually have a couple laugh out loud moments. And you're like, I can't believe I'm enjoying this. And then it just zooms ahead.
Dude, because I'm looking for new Christmas movies.
That's what
I
need. I do a lot of the same ones and I kind of want some new classics.
Before we get into the final question, where do you stand on Die Hard as a Christmas movie? It's so controversial.
I think there's no, it's an absurd that it's a controversy.
Exactly.
It's a Christmas movie, 1,000%. I just watched Die Hard. In fact, I took a little trip. I was alone in a hotel room and Die Hard came on and I'm like, this is jolly.
It's so
I
Christmas.
Laid there and watched it. And yeah, that's the whole thing I was thinking. I'm like, there's Christmas scenery in every scene.
Sleigh bells are part of the music.
Yeah, I mean, it's a Christmas movie.
Ho, 100%. Ho, ho. Now I have a machine gun.
exactly.
Come on.
Exactly.
Now I have a machine gun.
Wearing a Santa hat, for crying out loud.
Yeah.
Even the end, when he has the gun taped on his back, it's like holiday tape. It's like, come on.
Yeah, for sure. There's no controversy at all. Yeah. I love Die Hard, though.
Hell
the first one. Wow. So much.
One of the best of all time.
Yeah.
No doubt.
Yeah.
So, Don, we talked about just holiday plans, holiday things. What about the day of? Do you have any, like, Christmas Day traditions, or do you have any Christmas Day plans for this year?
This year is a little not 100% nailed down because we are traveling. We're going to go up to an undisclosed location, okay? But we are going to spend some time with some family. Yeah, a little bit out of the city. So I don't know exactly, but usually in the past, we spend it with family. So we go to a lot of times my wife's family on Christmas Eve. They celebrate a lot of times. So we'll go over to their place in the evening in the past. And then stay there super late, you know, and then the next day just have a little Christmas at home and then maybe, you know, check out my mom's house later if we're close by and stuff.
Nice.
So just usually go and see the families and stuff like that on Christmas Eve and on Christmas Day.
Same. I'm doing the Christmas Eve my side, Christmas Day her side. Yeah. That's it.
I've already started drinking eggnog. You know, it's the only time of the year. Do you ever drink eggnog?
You know, a year ago was the first time that I did it as an adult.
Yeah.
And I need to do it again this year. I was like, okay, this is a good first step. Because as a kid, I thought it was disgusting.
Yeah.
I was like, I don't want anything to do with this. Give me the apple cider.
Oh, I love apple cider.
You know?
Yeah.
So as a kid, eggnog was always no, no, no. But then last year, actually, I was like, I haven't tried it in like a decade at least.
Yeah.
I was like, hey, this is pretty decent, but I don't want to push it.
Yeah.
So now, psychologically, I'm open to it.
Yeah.
So this year,
they have some interesting ones. If you're not crazy about the regular, I found out I was drinking an oat nog.
oat nog. Like
they have this oat milk. Have you ever tried this? Oat
milk? I've had oat milk, yeah.
Yeah, so it's oat nog. And it was yummy. It was delicious. You might like it better. If eggnog doesn't appeal for you, a little too rich. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Spike it a little bit, maybe?
Yeah, maybe, if you want to go. Yeah. Yep, yep. So, yeah, that's what I'm going to be doing. Drinking some nog. Yeah. Very classical.
Hell
Clear
yeah.
Smith. Old fashioned.
Sick. All right, everyone. That was Don Casanova's Holiday Vibin'. Holiday music, movies.
I'm going to be playing some Jurassic World Evolution 2, and it's very appropriate that it snows in the game now, so I'm super
looking for... Do they have, like, holiday theming at all or not?
I haven't heard anything yet about that, but the snow is pretty jolly. Yeah. You get, like, blizzards and everything gets totally whiteout conditions. So, I'm looking forward to spending some hours there.
Heck yeah.
Park.
All right, Don, thanks so much. Thanks for, obviously, Huber Syndrome every
thank
year.
Thank you,
I love to
Huber.
Thank you at the end of the year for it all. Just the workhorse.
Absolute pleasure.
Getting it done, keeping us afloat.
Absolute pleasure.
Happy holidays, everyone. Merry Christmas. And just hug the ones you love. Yeah. And just relax and enjoy your time with your family. That's it. Love and respect.